all of this right here has just become obsolete. This right here is over $1,000, and there's more. This isn't even all the pack out stuff that I bought. I bought this stuff beginning of this year, and these came out shortly after the beginning of this year. Now, the problem with these and why they're obsolete and why I'm telling you don't make the same mistake I did, the big problem with these, let's say you need a fastener or some nails from this box down here that we used to keep our fasteners in. Well, what that means is everything on top of this now has to come off, and then you got to rebuild the tower when you're ready to roll out. Now, this obviously is an exaggeration. I don't think anybody really rolls around their pack out stuff this high. But the point is, we do stack them up probably about this high. And when we're rolling out of a job site or something, we're getting stuff organized and we need something from the bottom. It's just annoying to have to take all that off, get what you need, stack it all back up. It's really annoying. So that's where these come in. I honestly, if I could go back and do it, I would just not buy any of that and only buy these. So I started out with these two drawers, and I couldn't find a three drawer anywhere online. And then Home Depot just randomly started stocking these like this week, these three drawers. I went to Home Depot, picked this up, this three drawer, and I probably will get one more of these. I've got two more of the two drawers on the way, and I'm gonna basically convert all of that to this. So if anybody wants to buy some slightly used, just pack out gear, maybe I'll sell it on eBay or something. Now, inside of these drawers, I'll go ahead and open them up. They have these, or before you open them up, there's this bar right here that holds them during transport and just slides out of the way. It's super cool. Slides out of the way, so when you're driving, these aren't just gonna slide open. So if I need to get something, let's say from this drawer right here in the middle. So I got fasteners, screws, nails, some bits in there. If I need something from this drawer, I've got my multi-tool blades, jigsaw blades, some drivers, Sharpies, just some bits in there. What do I got in here? We got batteries, battery chargers, and batteries up there too. Down here, I've got kind of like miscellaneous hand tools, clamps. This is so convenient. These are 100 times better than those. Like, even my wife, she saw me working with these and she saw I had them all under the miter saw, and I went to like grab something. She's like, whoa, it's like you have your own like shop here. And I'm like, yeah, you're starting to get it. You're starting to, you know, we got to get more tools. Even she saw the value in it. And this has been something that, like I said, I should have waited. Don't make the same mistake in getting this stuff. Now, if you need this stuff and this works out better for you, then, you know, obviously go that route. But if I could go back, I would not do it this way, not at all. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this stuff. I could give it to my kids as toy boxes, I don't know. But I'm getting more organized as time goes on. If you check out back here, come check this out in the back of the truck. So I need to get a cart, or they have that dolly thing that you can stack these up on, because these don't have wheels. So I'm thinking of, I'm not gonna get that dolly, but I'm just gonna get that little cart that you could slide these onto. And then you can just roll it in or roll it around. But check this out. So in here now, I've got this little shelf going across, because basically I never put anything up here. It's just a bunch of wasted space. So I've got the table saw up here, table saw stand right there, extension cord, Castle pocket machine, and then you guys know the cut hub is up here. So that creates this space under here that I can use now. And this thing really doesn't stay right here, this DeWalt toolbox. It goes more to the side. Then I have my sprayer right there and a vacuum right there. But since those things aren't here, this bungee cord kind of pulls it to the middle. But yeah, this thing right here will slide around like crazy if I don't have it bungee. Like, I can hear it slam into the back of the bed here. So in the back seat here, I kind of built this little platform out of leftover 1x6s. And it's kind of a backseat delete. And I've had this for a while. I actually need to extend it a little more towards the back here to get more support. But this is, I made this when I still had the backseat in here. And the backseat took up about this much room, and I would have pack outs stacked in here. So when I took it out, I gained about that much. and I need to add like an extension to this platform, which will be really easy to do. And I was looking up RAM backseat deletes, and they actually have one. It's pretty cool, but it's like $700, and I'm not gonna do that. So just gonna use those boards for now, but these things will stack up. I just slide these in here, and then if we need to do something, like the other day, we were doing a job and I needed something from the bottom, I just came over here, got it, pulled it out, and grabbed. And I was actually, when I needed that item, I forgot what it was, but when I needed it, I was kind of like, I just loaded all that stuff up. And I was like, wait, I got the drawers now. So I just walked out here with a big smile, opened it up, pulled out what I needed, and then I walked in with a big smile too. So it's pretty cool. I can also bungee these in place too. I've got these hooks right here. I think these are for car seats actually. These hooks, you hook your car seat to it, but I could just strap a bungee cord around. And I haven't even done that, and these things don't even, they don't even move still without the bungee. So if I just wanted a little bit more security, they kind of wobble around a little bit when I hit bumps. But other than that, these things are a huge improvement. Highly recommend the drawers. If you can avoid these, I'd avoid them if at all possible. And oh, by the way, the ladder rack, that's another thing that's got us organized. Made a video about that one several months ago, and it's been working out great. This is actually two of every ladder I own. So we own more than these, but this is two of them. We got our two extensions, our two 10 footers, two 8 footers, and two 6 footers up there. This thing works out really good. And then I have them all strapped on just with like Husky straps from Home Depot. But yeah, these ladders fit up here nicely. A little bit of wind noise, but most of the time, you know, I'm wearing headphones anyways while I'm on the road making calls and whatnot. But yeah, I think these things right here are gonna be obsolete for sure because of the drawers. And I think one of the